How's it going? Welcome to this vlog. I thought it might be cool to start this vlog watering my plants, because it's kind of become a thing that I end my vlogs watering my plants, which, you know, I would have done and maybe I will do for this vlog depending on the kind of timeline that we're working with, but I needed to water my plants today. So here we are. Welcome. I just wanted to get a vlog started. This one is probably going to be like a normal weekly vlog or like week and a half kind of vlog. Because I have a bunch of to-dos that I would like to get done, and I thought it would be nice to grab them or do them with an audience, aka you guys. So that's what this is. Last time I watered my plants, I spilled a bunch of water here because these three that kind of live on this shelf, I need to bring down to water, and I just use my big expensive printer as a table. So probably not like the smartest thing to do, I would say, but now I know just to be a little more careful. That's the takeaway, I think. So yeah, settle in, grab your whatever you're working on, whatever errands you're doing right now, whatever task, or if you're at work, cool. Watch my vlogs on company time, fully supportive of that. And let's get into it. This will probably be another long one because that's kind of been my vibe lately. So it's been nice, you know. I feel less pressure to kind of edit my videos down or like edit my like talking portions and stuff like that. I used to cut around my every little like or pause in speaking, and I feel like, I don't know, sometimes listening to somebody talk about something when it's so, like, edited down and, like, condensed, it's sometimes, like, hard to follow 100%. It's hard to digest, maybe, what the person is talking about. The other day, I rewatched my big shop video or whatever, you know, the one, the everything I did to launch my art shop. Or whatever, because I am reopening my shop tomorrow. My patrons already have access to it, because that's like an early access thing that, you know, people get with being a patron of mine. But yeah, I was rewatching that video because, I don't know, I can use it as a resource for myself as well, and I feel like it's a reminder that I've done all of this before. So I can do it again, and I don't have to be afraid or anxious about it. So yeah, and that video is just like completely edited to fuck. And it's like good, you know, the video is still super long, and I feel like if I didn't edit it in a way that was like, that made my speaking very concise, it would have been even longer. So I think it is good that I edited that way, but I still feel like some parts were kind of hard to catch, or like, you know, sorry, I'm so close now. I need to go into the other room to water a plant, but okay, I'm just gonna keep talking. You know, I did feel it was easy to to miss points or like not be able to fully internalize what I was saying because I was like speaking so fast and everything was edited so quickly. There was a lot of information packed super dense. So yeah, I don't know. That was just something that I noticed, especially in comparison with like my recent videos where I don't do that as intensely, that style of editing. Did I miss anybody? Raise your hand if you didn't get water, guys. Okay, this one needs to go to the sink. Same with that one. Check, check, check. But yeah, anyways. As you can see, I have a lot of plants. I kind of go through phases of like feeling like I want new plants or like maintaining my plants or, you know, propagating, taking care of them, you know, regular maintenance things. And this guy right here is getting a little bit unruly and he's growing a little bit too much and too fast. As you can see, like it's starting to get so high that it's like leaning over this way. It's tied to this bookshelf, and if it wasn't, it would like fall over fully. So I'm kind of thinking it's time to snip a little bit, just off the top, and then start again with another plant. I don't know if this one's in frame, but there's another one that has come off of this big guy. And then same with this one too, this like cactus. I don't know what to do about this. Like, can I just cut the like cactus chunk, and then what will happen then? Will it keep growing? I don't know, because this one's literally almost touching the ceiling and it's still growing. And I don't know why. Like, I neglect this one a lot. I figure because it's a cactus, it doesn't really like being messed with too much. So, let's perform some plant surgery. No anesthetic, unfortunately. Okay, so you're supposed to cut the like last sprout or whatever that you see. If you cut above that, then the new growth will grow in that direction. So I kind of want it to point this way because it's leaning this way. So to create some balance, maybe here. Ooh, all right. Quick and painless, right? Okay. Sorry, bud. Oh my god, it's so short now. What the heck? And then yeah, for the longest time, I did not know how to propagate this guy. It's an umbrella tree or a schefflera, I think it's called. But I watched like some videos on how to properly propagate it, and it's really not that hard. This one piece is probably too big to just like propagate in a single jar. So I'm gonna cut it in half. And then I think you want to like take off some of these guys, just a couple of them. And then that's kind of like your stem where the roots will grow out of. And then I think the key is like you don't want too many of the thingies growing on a single stem, because then it's like too much for like the little growing root system that the plant will like become overwhelmed, and then it'll just die instead of continuing to grow. See, little umbrella, so cute. So these ones are Garbo. And then I think I'll put both of them in this thing. And then you're just supposed to swap out the water once a week-ish, so that you can get water with fresh oxygen in it. Okay, I think I'll put it up on my shelf. Up here. Oh god. This one is trying to escape. Oh god, now the other one. All right. What a mess. Okay, will you two behave? I really don't want to drop this entire fucking jar. Oh, okay! He really does not want to be in there, does he? Okay, I'm sorry. Just get back in there with your brother. Okay, they like want to escape, but I think they're good now. I know these three have to go back up there, but whatever, I'll figure out a space for them. So ta-da. So yeah, like I said, it is... the afternoon / early evening. And holy moly, I'm feeling a little low energy. I think maybe because I did lower body today, so that is always very draining. So I think I'm gonna make a little cup of green tea, a little caffeine boost, if you will. And yeah, I talked about this in my last vlog, but I am planning on, you know, taking a step towards being being represented by an illustration agent or joining some sort of illustration agency. And I feel like I've been, you know, I've mentioned that concept a couple times so far. And now I'm really starting to kind of hype myself up to, you know, prepare my portfolio and put together some new pieces that will kind of help supplement that or prepare me for that. But I know there is a level of, like, I could definitely just send off my current portfolio and my current work to multiple agencies just to see what people think. And I'm sure, I don't know, who knows, you know, I might get a couple of responses back. I don't know. But it's kind of a big step and I'm kind of overthinking it. And I don't know if it's like, obviously like fear of failure comes into play, but also like, I think it's valid in a way, because, you know, if I'm going to apply to certain agencies that I would really like to consider me, but my portfolio isn't the best that it can be right now, then it just feels like kind of a waste if I, you know, send it to them when it's not exactly 100% ready, when it's only maybe like 90% ready. And to be fair, like, maybe that's just something that I'm telling myself, that, like, I need to wait, I need to do more, I need to prepare before it's a good idea to actually send these along, and I'm just kind of, like, trying to buy time because I'm terrified. Which, you know, two things can be true at once. So yeah, that's kind of what I've been thinking about lately and what I'm gonna try and focus on moving forward, just outside of my day-to-day responsibilities, my client work and my Patreon stuff that I need to do, as well as opening the shop back up and thinking about, you know, how I want to continue my whole shop vibe and think of new products and things like that. So yeah, I'm working on a few illustrations currently.
It, so one of them, it was supposed to be for Patreon, and I was like kind of etching away at it, thinking about it, and trying to like make it in a way that would kind of fit into a genre of illustration that I have been seeing a lot in the agencies that I would like to apply to. I'll grab my iPad so you guys can actually see what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is kind of where I'm sitting. So as you can see, it's like there's a tree and there are a couple of birds and like there's a girl on a couch kind of like who has fallen asleep with like a book or whatever. I was trying to like make this kind of surreal-ish narrative of like a girl was like reading in her apartment, she fell asleep, and then the stuff from outside, like the trees and the birds and stuff like that, kind of came in through her window and started to like take over and is just like sitting around her and like watching her sleep. And so this is supposed to be for Q week. So the word I was going for was quiet. And I was thinking of the saying, like, let your quiet mind listen. It's like a quote from some fucking philosopher, I don't know. And so I was just trying to portray, like, the essence of, like, what quiet feels like. And quiet feels like to me, just like, you know, reading your book, the sun setting, you're inside, there's, you know, nobody else there. But then adding in that, like, additional narrative of like the outside world kind of coming in, and the quiet of nature kind of being able to be there in the room with you and you're not waking up. It's a little far-fetched, I don't know. I was trying to like force this this scene and this composition that feels a little bit unnatural to me, or like I'm kind of unsure about. So I was messing around with it a lot, and then I kind of did like a draw over, change the composition like a teeny tiny bit. It's really messy, but it's just like a thumbnail type sketch type thing, and I'm liking it a little bit better. I don't know how well the like ratio of the illustration is, you know, lending to the composition, or like if I should continue to change things. I don't know. So yeah, I've kind of moved on from that for now, and I'm just gonna kind of sit on it. I do want to finish it. I've been trying to tell myself lately, like, I'm doing myself a disservice by not finishing things that I start, and I feel like I have this mentality, and I always have, since I was a kid, which made sense growing up for sure, when I was still kind of developing and gaining skills and getting better at, you know, illustration and whatever. I had this mentality of, you know, I can't do this yet because I'm not good enough, so I need to get good enough first and then I can do it. And then maybe it'll, you know, be able to come out perfect. Which that kind of thinking is inherently flawed, because of course there is no thing as perfection. And by, you know, stopping yourself for the sake of perfection from, you know, creating something or from finishing something, or, you know, taking the step to like do something that you want to do because you think you're not good enough yet, that's like that stops you from creating. It keeps you from what you love to do and what you should be doing and what the world wants you to do, which is to create. And so yeah, I'm trying to nail that in my head. It's hard with this because I feel a little bit lost, and I don't know how it's gonna turn out, but I know in my heart that like I am obviously good at what I do. I can trust in my skill and my knowledge,
And if I were to finish this and just like say fuck it and take it over the finish line and stop finicking with it, it'll turn out fine. You know, it'll turn out good. So yeah, so that's that one. And then, so I was like, kind of like, oh, I don't know. And then, so I started another one. I was thinking, okay, so in addition to, for Q week, the word being quiet, I kind of wanted this one to be like fall themed, because it's going to be for October. And I was thinking about doing something like spooky or something, but like I'm not a huge spooky type person. Like that whole aesthetic of like, I don't know, Halloween-y type vibes isn't really me as much as like, which is surprising because I like to draw demons, but to me, like Japanese folklore and like demons and stuff like that don't give Halloween-y to me. And my last Patreon illustration was a demon, so I don't really know if I want to do that again. So I just started working on like a still life with no reference of what the fuck I was trying to draw here on my still life. It's a little hedgehog that's like eating some pears on a plate, and then there's like a latte in the background and some flowers. I don't know. I thought maybe like, oh, like a still life is very quiet, you know? What's more quiet than a bunch of things sitting there stilly? And then a hedgehog, because I wanted some sort of animal, and hedgehogs are like kind of like fall-ish and cute and quiet relatively. So yeah, I was doing that. I feel like if I'm gonna do a still life, I kind of want to, you know, really go hard with it and like send it and get these items and take like actual reference photos. That's kind of, you know, what still lives are. Like, you're supposed to kind of look at something and put it in front of you on a canvas. And then, so yeah, got tired of that. Gonna hit pause on that. I don't want to say I'm giving up on these things. And then I was thinking of another thing to, again, like with the prompt of like doing my Patreon thing. Which is in my sketchbook. So one second, let's go to my desk. Okay. So yeah, then I was like, you know, thinking with those past two illustrations that I was attempting, I was kind of like stuck on them. I feel like I was trying to force myself to do things that aren't really my vibe or not something that I would really want to do naturally. So then I was thinking like, okay, what do I want to do? What do I want to draw? And that's people, that's girls, that's plants, flowers, nature. So then with that in mind, I started thinking about, so like how can I take the aesthetic or like the feeling of fall and kind of relate it to the word quiet. And I feel like fall and, you know, the days getting shorter, the weather getting colder, just like the move into the colder seasons kind of on their own have like a sense of quiet to them, you know? So then I was thinking about that concept and like how, I don't know, as it gets darker outside and colder, it's quieter inside and outside, I guess. Like the animals are sleeping, there's not as much like activity. Everybody's just kind of holed up in their homes hibernating. And so I was thinking about that. And how that's kind of like cozy and fall and quiet and yada yada. And then so I'm thinking about like a composition like this one. They're basically the same. Of just like a girl sitting and it's like kind of dark and she's hugging her cat and it's quiet and there are fall trees in the background.
And then this morning, another idea came to me of like, what if I put like a little light source on the inside of her, either like a candle or just like, I don't know, maybe not like a physical item, just like a glow or something. And then I made her, like her body, kind of like translucent so that you can see the light, the light source coming in from inside of her. This is really bad, like I literally just scribbled this in just now, but like, do you get what I mean? It's not like that, like better, but you know, a light source coming from the inside, and that kind of speaks towards like the contrast between like the cold dark outside versus like the warm inside and the coziness that, you know, fall and moving into the colder weather brings. So that's where I'm at. That's where I've kind of landed, and I think I like that. I think I'm going to go with this one for my Patreon postcard. It is September 17th today, so just about halfway through the month, so I have to get this finished by the end of the month, so it should be totally doable. And then, yes, I would like to do it in a way that, you know, is in like a bit of a experimental style that would be nice to include in my portfolio, just to show some reach. What is the word I'm thinking of? Show some range. That's the plan. That's where I'm sitting. And yeah, I would like to shoot some reference for this, of just like the pose of like sitting like this. I think that would be helpful to me. I don't have a cat. I wish I did. I'm allergic to cats, unfortunately. So maybe I'll just like hug a fucking pillow or something. We'll figure something out there for the cat, but yeah. That is what we have going right now. Welcome to the vlog. Okay, so, hi. Gonna shoot this reference. I'm not like 100% sure what I want for the lighting, so I'm doing it over here, not in any direct lighting. It's also the evening, so the sun's kinda low anyways. But I kind of like how it's a little bit backlit and there's like some reflection on the ground. I don't know if that's gonna make any difference at all. For the most part, I just want like flat lighting so that I can like see things clearly. But I changed into this little fit. It's like kind of like giving fall. It's kind of cozy. I don't know what to use for my cat though. Okay, this needs to turn towards me so I can actually see myself in frame. Okay. What can I use as a cat? Oh, I have a stuffy! Yeah! This is about the size of a cat, right? everyone, this is Lion. This is a stuffed animal that I've had literally since I was a baby. He's actually older than I am. It was my sister's first, and then I got a different one. But then when I was born, like, we traded or something, so my sister has one and I have one. If you saw her her room tour or whatever, she shows hers. Hers is a dog named Doggy. And mine's a lion named Lion. And he used to have like an actual mane, but obviously like through the years of me just like cuddling him to death. Oh, this is so nice. Oh, I missed him. Yeah, his hair just got like all flat and matted, but he will be acting as my little cat in the reference. Okay, so do I want my hair down or up? probably up, right? And then I can draw it down if I want to, and that's pretty easy.
Okay, so yeah, I haven't shot reference in a long time, but basically what I do is set up my camera, do a little video, and then just kind of pose in the video. I feel like I'm too far back. I feel like I need to be kind of sitting on something. Because I want, like, my legs to be relatively straight. I wish my legs were longer, because then I could do better angles. Okay, one sec. It's just like a seat pillow thingy to kind of elevate me. And then line. Line's probably a little bit small. I want my arm to be like, God, I wish my fucking legs were longer. So my knees would be up here and it would come up. But I can edit that. And then so the cat is supposed to be like that. And then, how do I want my arm, my hand posed? It's kind of weird because I have lying like off to the side so that you can see like the body, but maybe if I bring him in a bit. I don't want my arm to cover him though. And then I think I want her eyes closed. Just gonna get some angles of my head. But again, that can be edited once I have the back straight. Oh, I'm actually like gripping a lot with my core. This is tiring. Okay, let's see how that looks. I don't like my hand position. So what can we do about that? The thing about like my anatomy, which I really wish this wasn't the case, but I have very short arms and legs. That's just how I'm built, right? Which like, this is why like people who are models like tend to have longer limbs because you could do such like cool angles with your body, and I'm a little bit limited in how I can do that. I feel like hand reference is one of like the most important things. Maybe just like draped or under, maybe. What's nice too is I can, you know, scrub through the video here and then screenshot a bunch of them and then just like literally like Frankenstein my reference. Okay, I think this will be fine. I'm just gonna pretend like my knees are higher. See what that looks like. Okay, I'm sure we got it in one way or another. I'll figure it out.
Bye, guys. Whee! 'Ching away at this first kind of initial sketch, figuring out my composition for my little illustration thingy, and I am liking it so far.
I kind of put some tones and values just to kind of get a decent idea of what I'm thinking, foreground versus background. I ended up going with a little like window setup, so it does feel like it's kind of like real space, and like a kind of like an indoor setting, even though it is like pretty graphic and like flat and straight on kind of. But yeah, I think it's good. I'm not 100% sold on it yet. Something that I am thinking about doing maybe is like adding some objects or something like down here. Because right now it's like she's sitting on a windowsill or something like that, or like some sort of nook right beside a window. So that's kind of like that cozy vibe, but it feels a little empty for it to be kind of I want it to feel a little more like lived in and cozy, and right now it feels a little bit too empty for that. So I'm thinking like maybe it would be cool to like add some like books sitting beside her, as if she's like sitting on a bookshelf, because I feel like the pose itself is very like compact, and the way that like the body is shaped, it kind of feels like she's trying to like be a book. So it might be cool to like add some other things that like might live on a bookshelf like beside her here and here. And then yeah, I'm just gonna continue to play and maybe fill in some more background stuff, but I'm liking where it's going, feeling good about it. And yeah, just gonna keep exploring and see where I land before I go in to do the final. So that's gonna be my night. I will probably put on a show. I would like to make some tea, but I only have green tea, and I don't think I should have caffeine right now because it's 8. So yeah, just gonna keep working, have a cozy night, and we'll check back later on. Okay, Heller. How's it going? Excuse my... This is how I always look. I don't know why I feel the need to say anything if I'm not done up or anything. You guys know what I look like. Yeah, so it's evening. Again, we've jumped to the evening. I spent my day working on some client stuff, went to the gym, did some more client stuff, and then now I'm continuing work on this Q Week illustration. Like, I'm sure all of you guys have heard me say this before, but in case y'all are confused by what I mean, when I say Q Week, is, I feel like every now and then I should explain what the fuck I'm talking about. I was taking part in a thing called Alphabet Superset, where you were supposed to make something each week kind of thing. So it was supposed to last 26 weeks, 1 week per letter of the alphabet. And then you were supposed to, you know, make something based on something that started with that alphabet letter. I don't know why I don't know why my brain is buffering so slow right now. Anyways, so I started that. That was in, that was literally a year ago. And I'm on Q Week for a while. I was, you know, staying consistent with doing them week by week, or like, you know, every once in a while it would take like a couple weeks or whatever, and I was on a roll. And then I stopped being on a roll, and now I'm just trying to finish, and I'm on the letter Q. So we're almost there. We're making our way through. But yeah, like I said last night, this is what I kind of landed with. And then I did add in some of these like little thingies down here, and I like it a lot. It feels like cute and kind of funny. Like, she's kind of just like forced her way into this bookshelf thing and she's just kind of sitting there and whatever. So yeah, I'm liking it a lot. It's feeling good. And then I just went in and kind of lined her ish, but I'm trying to take this approach, if it'll truly focus, I'm trying to take this approach where my line work is really just a more detailed sketch, or like a bit more of like a tighter sketch. Because yeah, I don't know, I feel like my, you know, perfectionist brain, the automatic thought is that like, okay, I'll do my sketch, then I'll do my line art, and my line work will be perfect and smooth and without any jitters or anything. Like, I've really trained myself to be able to draw these like very smooth, very like, I don't want to use the word calligraphic because that's not accurate, but you know what I mean, like very precise line work. That is like completely different from a sketch. And I don't know how I feel about that. I feel like it has its place, you know, like certain drawings or certain styles of illustrations. I feel like that kind of line work is good. And it feels very like clean and refined and whatever, but just as I was drawing, sitting here in silence or whatever, trying this kind of new thing that feels a little bit unnatural to me, I've just been reflecting on, you know, I feel like in the past, like, many years, I feel like especially since I've graduated school, I have really found a love for artwork and art styles that kind of, like, celebrate imperfections and, like, do a lot of like very human mark making and like feel more sketchy or like painty or like, you know, it's not refined. And yeah, so I'm trying to be very intentional about how I'm going about this piece. I feel like my last piece that I did for Patreon was very like, obviously, like super clean cut, you know, it was very like, it's literally symmetrical. So
I'm just maybe craving something that feels a little less that. And I don't know how well you can see, but if I zoom in here, like, for example, on the hand or whatever, I'm sure, like, you guys could have seen in the process, but, like, these lines, these strokes are imperfect. They're very much, like, kind of, like, etchings and just, like, you know, human mark making. And I like it a lot. I forget if I said this in, like, the little intro chat that I did in this video, but I'm looking at my art and looking at my style under a microscope right now and, like, really thinking about it because of the context around, like, I'm going to be trying to become a part of an illustration agency, and I'm just, like, overanalyzing my work and past illustrations that I've done, and I'm, like, trying to figure out what I like, or, like, what the fuck my style is. And I know that I have a style, I know that my art tends to look a certain way because I can't help the way that I draw, more or less, but, like, I do play around a lot with, I don't know, like, treatments and, like, color palettes and, like, different, like, I experiment a lot with my art, I feel. Maybe it's that feeling is less obvious from the outside looking in, but, yeah. I've literally, like, the past couple nights before I go to bed, I'm, like, laying in bed looking up at the ceiling thinking, like, who am I? What is my art, even? So yeah, I don't know. I've just been kind of thinking a lot about my work and doing this just now in a way that was, you know, it kind of happened effortlessly for me, and I really like how it's looking so far. I just thought I would share that. And who knows what my next drawing will look like, or the one after that, truly. But those were just some thoughts that I was thinking about as I was working on this one. Also, cats are hard to draw, huh? I realized, like, I'm not super comfortable with drawing cats, or I guess animals, to be fair, just in general. Haven't drawn a lot of those in my lifetime, but they're cute. I wish I could have a cat so bad. Maybe someday. So yeah, my rice is on, so I'm gonna prepare dinner, eat it, put on a show, and then continue to etch away at this thing. Show me out.
Hey guys, good morning. How's it going? Yeah, as you can probably see, it's not buttfuck early. It's actually just very gloomy outside, so it's looking very dark inside. But yeah, how's it going? How are you? Let me see where I can put this. Yeah, I hate to be in the same sweater in every single shot, but what can I say, you know, it's my favorite sweater, it's the coziest, it's the comfiest, and today, like I said, is super gloomy, so it's like a perfect day for this sweater, again, and yesterday was a perfect day, and the day before that. but yeah, hi. Today's Friday. My day is, like, pretty, it's looking pretty open and free, which is cool. I finished like pretty much everything I needed to do this week in terms of like work stuff, client stuff. And yeah, last night I just kind of continued working on that Q-week illustration until I went to sleep, and liking where it's, you know, headed. I just like kind of filled in the frame or whatever, the like window where that lives. You guys will see later. And yeah, I'm just kind of continuing to do that. Hi. I just journaled / felt my feelings or whatever. I've talked about before what I do, I guess, when I do this shit. Or I guess it's kind of changed over time. I started reflecting or like checking into myself or like feeling my feelings after my therapist recommended that I take just like 5 minutes every morning with my coffee to just like pay attention to how I feel, write down any emotions that are coming up, whatever. So it started with that, and I would just write down like literally like words on a post-it note every morning, just one post-it note. And sometimes I would like doodle little like characters or like whatever I'm feeling. And it just started with that, just literally sometimes like a few words, like anxious, slow, maybe a little down, or sometimes I was feeling a little bit better, so I would write like clear or, you know, whatever, like very, very simple. That's where it started. Prior to that, I had never really been that much of a journaler in the sense of like journaling for my mental health and journaling to take care of myself. Whenever I journaled, it was more of like a, I didn't know what to write. I would just like kind of write down what I did that day or like the last day, or like I would like plan for the future or whatever. Like I didn't know how to have that relationship with myself, you know? And so that like reflected in my journaling. So yeah, when I started, that's what it was. It was very simple, whatever, like I would just sit down for a few minutes. And then from there, it has kind of evolved. I don't know what like the steps were that it kind of like has turned into something more. But as of late, and you know, eventually it's kind of morphed into like a proper journaling session, which is very interesting. That, you know, it, like I journal now, and that's never been something that I've done or something that I've always struggled with. But yeah, now when I sit down with my journal or whatever, with my coffee, because coffee is, you know, I love coffee. Not even the drink, just the ritual of it and the coziness, and it's just these moments in the morning where I do get to have my coffee. It's my favorite. I love it so much. I'm very grateful for it. So yeah, I pair it with this thing that I love, and I kind of just like start with asking myself how I feel. So I start with like the way that I would journal or whatever when I first started, focusing on like any emotions, trying to name them. And I kind of go from there. So for example, right now, or today, I feel a little bit anxious. And so I write that down. I feel a little maybe slow today, probably because it's gloomy.
So I start there, and then I think, like, okay, so I'm feeling this way. Maybe let's think about why, or dig into one of these. So I'm like, okay, why am I feeling anxious? And then that expands into, you know, oftentimes if I'm like stuck onto like a worry or something, I'll write down that worry, which is usually like completely illogical and totally emotional and, you know, doesn't really have any legs. So I'll write down the worry, and I feel like even just doing that helps me look at it, and already if I read it back, I can be like, okay, that's not true. Like, that's a little bit much. And so I'll write that down, get that out of my system, and then I'll write down the truth, or like the self-compassionate, loving truth that I, you know, can think about and reassure myself with to ease the worry. And yeah, usually that just takes me into writing paragraphs and paragraphs about, like, you know, just very loving, self-compassionate things. And like everything that I'm doing here is with a foundation or with a basis of, I've learned how to connect with myself and speak with myself with love. And so these sessions, journaling and figuring out my emotions and kind of bringing my worries out in the open, it's all wrapped up in love and support and goodness within myself. So, yeah. And then if I feel like I'm still kind of stuck, or like I need some more connection with myself, I'll close my eyes and then I'll have a conversation with myself. I've talked about how I do this before, but it's literally like, here's my voice, and then there's another voice up here that is also me, and I imagine it as a conversation back and forth, and this person is like my best friend, or like a very loving, supportive voice, but it's me. So it's nice, and sometimes I need that. And then yeah, I just end off with reminding myself that I love myself, and, you know, all positive affirmations and things that I've, things that I have found that, kind of strikes a chord in me when I tell myself, like, something recently that has really moved me, is the concept or the notion that, you know, you don't need to be fixed. You were never broken. And that's nice, you know, because I feel like I'm, like I've said before, I'm a very solutions-oriented person. So I feel like with that context, whenever I am dealing with anything, or whenever, you know, I'm struggling or whatever, and I feel like, especially like this recent stint of me feeling not myself, or like a little empty or low or whatever, when I'm in that state, I'm just remembering how I used to be, and I'm comparing my low self to my high self, and it's hard for me not to think of my high self as normal, as not broken. And when I'm my low self, that comes with, like, if I'm hanging on to that comparison, that comes with a judgment of like, you're fucked up right now. We need to fix this immediately so we can get back to feeling good again, so we can get back to me again. But that's not loving. So coming at anything that I feel and anything that I'm struggling with the notion that, like, me at my lowest and me at my highest is the same person. Just because I'm struggling with something, or just because I'm dealing with negative emotions, doesn't mean that I'm not me in those moments. Doesn't mean that I'm broken in any way. Doesn't mean that I need to be fixed. It just means that I'm going through something. And that something will pass, as it always fucking does. And the highs and the lows and the positives and the negatives have always been a part of my life and will always be a part of my life. So it's not fair to myself to judge myself so harshly when I am feeling a little, just trying to get back to that high again. Because that judgment in my low periods will not do anything positive for me. It'll just add more pressure and negativity. So, yeah. Learning, trying to remind myself to accept myself radically in anything that I'm going through, in any of my shortcomings or failures or low periods. So, that's it. In terms of like the specifics of what I'm going through, it's, you know, it's just the normal like self-doubt, anxiety, stuff that I've talked about already, I feel like, which I know is normal. I'm talking about like self-doubt in terms of my art and my work and, you know, steps forward in these like scary moves that I'm trying to take. And so I know that I'll just, you know, continue to reassure myself, continue to be compassionate with myself. And I know that I will just fucking do it anyways. And I know that's what I have to do in order to, you know, get past this fake thing that's holding me back from doing the things that I want to fucking do anyways, that are not necessary or real in any way. I know that I just need to fucking do, so that's what I'm gonna do. So yeah, I just have to send off some client stuff this morning, and then I think I'm gonna continue etching away at that illustration. I'm feeling good after, you know, checking in with myself, and we'll see where the rest of the day brings me. Because it's Friday, baby.
Alrighty, hey guys. It's voiceover time. I feel like it's been a while since I did a voiceover, and I feel like I say that a lot. But I mean it this time, I really do. So yeah, I'm just continuing work on this Q-Week illustration. Yeah, like I said, I'm really liking how it's going. I'm liking the line treatment that I've kind of settled into for the style of the drawing, and now I'm just filling in some of the little like objects and stuff, the like books and the whatever else that is kind of living on this windowsill with the girl. And for reference of these things, I, other than this like Smisky lamp, which maybe by including it in my illustration I'm manifesting getting it, I really want this thing. But I just can't bring myself to spend, I don't know how much it is, like $60 or something, more than that, to get it. So I'm holding out. I'm thinking maybe the next time I go to Japan, I'll look for some Smisky stuff, but yes, I added this in because I think it's just cute, and it's a reference to like a real world object, and then I kind of had the idea to just pull books off of my bookshelf and then use those as reference rather than, I don't know, drawing like generic looking books as these objects that are on like beside me in the illustration. Something that we learned in school in like, I think like narrative illustration classes or things like that, where we were drawing settings or like interiors, is that to make a space feel real and lived in and convincing and like immersive, you want to be like as specific as possible with your items. So like a good reference for that is to pull actual objects, like for example from like things that you have, or you know, if you Google, I don't know, like a bedroom or something, and you zoom in and you look at all the little specific things that are there, specific pieces of furniture, specific like lamps, plants, things like that, the more specific you can get with these objects, the more believable the space will be. I feel like oftentimes, I don't know, if you're just like drawing like a really simple like idea of a space, and like somebody has a bunch of books on their shelf, then maybe the books will just say like math or dictionary, you know, just on there, instead of looking up like an Oxford dictionary or something and then seeing what the spine looks like there, and then drawing that. The difference between those things is like a lot of, I don't know, you're like, the more specific you get, the more the space feels realized, I guess. So that's what I was going for with this. And like I said, I used my own books. That was like the easiest thing that I could think of in terms of finding objects to draw, rather than thinking of relevant books to Google and find reference that way. So yeah, and I really like that I did that. I think it turned out nicely within the illustration. And then yeah, I just continue to work on the trees in the background here. I'll talk a little bit about my struggle with these in the next section, but yeah, something about trees is intimidating to me. I've never felt very natural about drawing any kind of nature that is like kind of, you're like zoomed out and there's like lots of little details, like a bush or a tree or grass, stuff like that kind of intimidates me, because I'm not entirely confident on how the best way is to simplify enough while still drawing like the impression of a lot of detail without drawing every single little detail. It's something that I think I struggle with and doesn't come super naturally to me. So, but yeah, landing on these trees in the style that I did, I am quite happy with, and I think fits nicely with the rest of the illustration. So, yeah.
Hi, good morning. How's it going? It's Saturday. And yeah. what time is it? It's around 9 a.m. And I have some lunch plans for like a little birthday lunch that I need to get to around 11. But until then, I do have some orders to pack. What the fuck? What is going on here? If anybody's wondering, this like laptop stand thingy that I use is from Moft. I got it a long time ago, like years ago. And it's just kind of, it's cool because it folds down flat or whatever, but I think because I've been using it for so long, obviously like this is all kind of fucked up. If I don't put anything like back here, behind here, then it'll just like kind of flip up and then go flat like that. So might need to look into getting something new for that. Either another one of those, or I don't know, something a little bit more like permanent and not made out of cardboard. I don't know what it's made of, but it does, it is very light, which I guess lends to the ability to just leave it on your laptop and fold it flat. Anyways, what was I saying? I need to pack some orders. Just a little handful of them.
that came in with my very casual shop opening.
Okay, let me get my desk situated and then I'll keep rambling to you guys. Okay, and now I'm gonna pack. I want to ramble as I pack, but I need to write like thank you notes and stuff like that and pay attention to what the fuck I'm doing so I don't mess anything up. So I'm gonna pack this, and then once everything is like sorted and I just need to put them in the envelopes and print labels and stuff like that, then I'll come back and then we can chat. So I packed everything in their envelopes, printed off postal things. You guys can't see the labels, right? It's too far away. Okay. I'm just trying to save myself some grief editing in post if I have to blur these out. So now I need to put do not bend stickers on and my return label, which is easy enough. These do not bend stickers, I actually had printed my very first time trying to sell art online when I did it on like Etsy and I got like 2 sales. Yeah, I printed like a fuck ton of them and only used 2. So I've been slowly making my way through the pile. I used these ones on these white mailers, which I got as well on my first little run trying to sell art online that didn't go very well, or it wasn't successful because I didn't know what the fuck I was doing and I didn't put enough effort into it, not nearly as much as I have this time around. So yeah, I've just been using them on the white because the my new mailers that I've gotten, you can see here. These ones are craft and they're like much more matte and absorbent. So they hold my do not bend stamp and the ink much better. And I'm worried to use the ink on this material because it's like a lot more kind of like glossy. It has a finish to it. So yeah, I don't want to use the stamp on these, so I've been using the stickers. Okay, that was an overreaction on my end. Apologies. But yeah, it's now 10:16, so I have like 45 minutes before I have to go. Maybe I'll leave a little bit earlier because I gotta stop at the post office. But yeah, it's the weekend. Woohoo! Last night I basically worked all night on that QWeek illustration. And yeah, it went well. You know, I had a nice time kind of turning my brain off and just adding in the little details and all that, just with the line work. Yeah, I got to a point where I was finished the like foreground elements, the books and stuff in the foreground, the window was done, I like filled in. Oh, what the fuck? I don't need that. Stupid. I don't actually need these because my returned address is on there. Cool. Okay, so these ones are done then. That's funny. Wasted one return address label. Yeah, so I finished the foreground elements line work. And I found myself procrastinating the background elements, the like trees and stuff in the background. And that's because trees are hard to draw. I feel like this is a struggle that isn't really talked about. Can we lose the taboo on talking about how hard trees are? Can I be controversial for a second? Yeah, trees, bushes, anything that has like a bunch of like detail in like lots of leaves or like even grass. I feel like if I'm not overly simplifying it or like making it kind of like cartoony looking, I don't know what the fuck to do, because like especially with this drawing that I was doing, that I am doing, all of the foreground elements and like the character that I have, those are all very realistic, you know? They're drawn with a lot of detail and attention, and they're based on life. So in approaching the trees, I was hesitant because I was like, okay, do I match the fidelity of what's in the foreground? The like level of detail, do I try to make it look realistic like I have with the stuff in the front? And I guess that scared me because I don't know. I don't actually know how to do that without like literally drawing every single leaf. So yeah, I found myself procrastinating doing that because I was scared. And I don't know, eventually I took a break, I took some time, I thought about it, and I was like, what the fuck am I doing? Why am I scared? And reflecting on it this morning, I think I was scared of being inefficient, or I was scared of like drawing the trees or like jumping into drawing the trees, doing something that I wasn't comfortable with or I didn't exactly know how to do in a way that fit the vibe or the aesthetic of everything else in the composition. Just fear of doing it and then not liking it and then having to redo it, and then the time that would waste. And so that is what was holding me back. And in turn, I was wasting more time procrastinating doing it and like fucking trying, you know? So it's that's what I was kind of thinking about this morning. I did end up, you know, like after I took some time and like breathed about it, I did, you know, I collected some other references. I saw how other artists, you know, do trees. And then I landed on a way to do them that I was pretty happy with and that did kind of match the vibe. Somewhere between like stylization and realism, which I think is a really sweet spot to land. So I am, like, I'm proud of myself because I'm happy with, you know, how it has come out and how I've done that. But yeah, it's interesting. My, I guess, like sensitivity around time or wasting it. When I was saying like wasting time earlier, in quotations, air quotes, I feel like the concept of wasting time, especially when it comes to doing something like art, isn't like a real thing, especially if it's like personal work or even client work, as long as you're, you know, within the like a reasonable time frame of working on the project in relation to how much you're getting paid, as long as that's like you're okay with that, then any time spent, even if it's like spent, you know, trying something, it not working out, having to like redo it, erase it, refigure things out, that's not time wasted, you know, or it's not like an inefficiency, because like that, those steps and those fuck ups and that like redo or whatever, that that the time spent figuring it out to get to the final product is necessary, right? Like you wouldn't be able to get to that finished piece that ends up being, you know, what you want, and just like hitting just right, you wouldn't be able to get there without, you know, trying and making a mistake maybe and then redoing it. And that goes for like, you know, practice or like sketchbooking or all of these things. You have to do and try and fail in order to get to the end, get to the goalpost. And it's not a waste of time. I had another thought, but now I can't remember it. Let me think. Actually, maybe I'll look at my journal. Maybe I wrote a lot about this. If any of you guys were watching back in like December, I think that's when I started it. November, December. This originally was supposed to be a sketchbook that I show nobody ever, to take the pressure off of myself from making like good sketches and just like sketchbooking freely, but it's fully turned into just a journal now. I literally just write in it. Right. I feel like me as a person, when I come at any task period, I come at it with a expectation or a pressure on myself to do it as efficiently as possible. And that's great for like, you know, school or work or like any task that, you know, you would benefit from it being more efficient and going by faster or going by in, you know, the most efficient way that it can. But I feel like I've really internalized that in everything that I do, including art and personal work. And obviously, like what I'm getting at here is for stuff like that, for art, for time spent, you know, in my leisure, you know, it's not for a client, it's not for work or anything. There's literally no reason why I need to hustle something like that along. It's silly. You know, like why would I want to rush through a process that is so beautiful and like it's what I enjoy doing the most. If I put this pressure on myself to be efficient in this thing that is meant to be relaxing or you know, like play to me, it just sucks all the fun out of it, you know? So yeah, I feel like that's what I was kind of thinking about yesterday when it came to those fucking trees. I don't know if any of that made sense. I feel like I'm having a hard time speaking today, or like, I don't know. I'm overthinking my thinking. My thought process is but yeah, that's all I wanted to say, I guess. That's what I was thinking about this morning. Thank you. Good morning.
Another day, another gray sweater scene in this vlog. How's it going? Yeah, it's another like slightly gloomy day, kind of overcast. But it's Sunday today, so I have the day to work on some illustration stuff. I want to go to the gym, and I want to film my October Patreon podcast today. I don't really have like a topic in mind or anything like that, nothing really that involved, but I have been wanting to do like a sketchbooking session or whatever, something very chill, very like real time, just to kind of emulate a sketchbook hangout or whatever, a POV if you will. POV, we're on a sketchbook date. But yeah, I'm just gonna start or continue working on this Q Week illustration. I was struggling a lot with colors. I forget if I mentioned that, but I've kind of landed on something that I don't hate. Mostly playing on like cool and warm. It's very rough right now. This like glow or whatever is just like a very rough indication, but I kind of like how it's, I was struggling because I want the frame to be dark, right? Because it's like a backlit or like a shadow, and then you can see outside, but it's also dark because it's supposed to be nighttime. So I was trying to make the outside cool and the inside warm because that's kind of the concept here. But then the cat is also supposed to be like the center of warmth. I know I talked about like putting a candle inside of the girl, but that didn't really work because the center of the girl is the cat. So I just thought like, what if the cat was the candle or whatever? And then that's like the center glow thing. So yeah, I wanted to make the inside warm and the outside cool, cause that was the concept. But then I was thinking like, but the trees are supposed to be like fall-ish, right? So like, shouldn't they be warm? And so I was trying to make the trees warm and the inside also warm, but then the background dark, but also the frame was dark because it's, I don't know, it's nighttime. So I was having trouble balancing that. So I let go of the trying to make the inside warm. Typically, like that's like a depth perception kind of tactic or whatever in visuals or in illustration, is that like if you make something warmer on a canvas, it will come closer and cooler things recede. So usually it's like, you know, cooler background, warmer foreground. But with this, yeah, I just thought that, you know, since the cat kind of needs to be the focal point and the cat is the warmth, then like what's around that needs to be cool. So I made the inside cool and the outside more warm, which is a little, you know, it's different, but I think it works, right? So it is very like muted right now, so I'm gonna play with maybe like punching things up a bit as I go in and actually finish this. But yeah, I think I'm happy where this is going, so I'm gonna continue. But yeah, hi, good morning. Yesterday was lovely. Saw lots of people, ran into lots of people that either like watch my channel or know my art or like I know their stuff or whatever, so that was cool. And then hung out with Sumin and Tyler and saw Stewie, so that was nice. And yeah, it was good. I feel like, I don't know, I've been in recent times or whatever, I've been kind of recovering from too much social interaction, right? So I was a little bit anxious going into yesterday, but yeah, it's interesting. I think I was craving social interaction, which is rare for me, but it does happen. And I'm happy that one of my weekend days was dedicated to spending time with people and being social and outside. So I feel full there, not drained, but you know, satisfied. And now today,
I'm looking forward to just sitting and being alone and in quiet and peace, maybe with a video essay or two in the background while I continue on this drawing.
Okay. Hi guys, I am currently setting up for my video podcast. Woo! And I am, oh, fuck. Sorry, there's a lot going on here. FaceTime, camera. Yeah, so, hi. I just got back from the gym. Today was leg day, so I'm feeling very drained. And that's like a great time to do a podcast, right? When you're very drained. So I'm trying to figure out my setup, because for these podcasts, like especially if I'm just gonna be like, if the plan is to sit and sketchbook for a while, I just wanna be able to sit and record and not worry about like battery life or anything like that. So I don't want to use this camera because my battery life on it has been quite shit lately. I have two batteries for it and both of them seem to drain very fast, like much faster than they used to, which I guess is just like I've had this camera and these batteries since 2019. And I bought it secondhand, so it definitely is beginning to deteriorate, I'm sure, in its like capacity or whatever. So yes, I'm thinking I'm just gonna use my like webcam camera and then my phone to record what I'm doing, my like drawing cam or whatever. So that'll be good, I think. The only thing is like the webcam quality will be bad, but I'll probably do the thing where I just like take my face and then shrink it down and put it in the corner anyways, so it doesn't really need to be high quality. The only thing that, you know, would need to be high quality is the drawing, so that my patrons can actually see what the fuck I'm doing. But yeah. I don't have much of a plan for filming, and like I said, I am feeling kind of drained. So I was thinking I would make a little notes thingy of like possible things I can talk about. So let's brainstorm. I'm needing to remind myself that like when I had the idea of doing these like monthly vodcasts or whatever for my Patreon, it was very much intended to be like chill, like so fucking chill. But my past, so I've done 3 episodes so far, and all of those episodes have been like, they've been chill, but they've required a lot of like preparation, or like they were all around like specific themes, or like I talked about very specific like topics and stuff like that. So I feel like I put a lot of weight on myself for those. And now this one, like I don't really have a topic, so I'm kind of stressing myself out. Like, oh, like how's it gonna go? Is it okay if I like take pauses and like don't know actually what the fuck to say? And yes, I'm sure that's fine, because that's like what I wanted this podcast to be in the first place. I just wanted to be like chill, chatty, hang out, whatever, you know? And then here I am writing a list of things that I could talk about. But, you know, baby steps, you know? I need to ease my way into being super chill and flowing naturally with these. Okay, so I'm gonna write down the concept of already being good enough art-wise. This is like something that I've been thinking about a lot lately, or like trying to remind myself as I'm like working on personal projects or like doing art. I'm trying to tell myself that like, and I forget if I talked about this on the vlog yet, but the concept that like, I'm already good enough at art. I don't have to get any better skill-wise to do the things that I want to do. And then in turn, I will get better at, like, skill-wise at art. Because I feel like so many of the things that I want to draw, that I put off, or like the projects that I want to work on, I put them off because I tell myself that I'm not good enough yet. Or I procrastinate things because I'm scared that they won't turn out because I'm not good enough yet. So it's kind of like leaning into the delusion or whatever that like, I know realistically, like I'm not the best, like most skilled artist in the world, but I know that I'm good enough that if I just like tell myself that I'm already good enough and I don't have to fucking try so hard to be perfect, that whatever I just allow myself to let go and create will be good. It'll turn out good. It'll turn out fine. I just need to be able to focus on, the creation rather than the, you know, stressing out about whether or not I'm good enough to do the creating. So I guess that's literally what I'll say on the podcast. I don't know. I'll just let myself ramble. Maybe I can talk about like how it's the fall. I can talk about, what am I thinking? I can talk about like October drawing challenges, because October is the big drawing challenge month and that's coming up, and anything else. Literally anything else doesn't matter. I will just yap as I do. Okay. It's hot in here. Are you guys hot? Just me? I feel like whenever I come back from the gym, especially leg day, because I do like, you know, my heaviest weights on leg day, I run very hot, like body temperature wise, for the next while. Maybe because like my fucking like adrenaline still pumping or whatever. Okay, my bad, sorry guys. Didn't mean to scare ya. But yeah, I just find myself like sweating like a hog well after I stop exercising. All right. Face cam looks good. Don't exactly know what I'm gonna draw. I'll probably just do a bunch of studies as I tend to and hope that it goes well. Fuck, I'm tired. Is this the right thing to be doing right now? Yes, fuck it, it's fine. I'm fine. Okay, I'm gonna get filming. But yeah, if you wanna see this particular episode of the Patreon pod, or any other episode, you can do my medium tier, my video tier or whatever on Patreon, and you get access to all of them. So yeah, link in the cards to my Patreon. Okay, bye. Okay, hello, how's it going? It's almost 9 p.m. and I've eaten dinner. I finished filming my podcast. I ate dinner. My water is fully ready. Yeah. I'm all cozied up for the night. I've been working on that Q Week illustration for the past little while. And so I have an update to show you guys, but first, I picked up this tea from the store today. I don't know how to open the box though. Oh, I see. Because I wanted something kind of like fall flavory, like a chai, but without any caffeine so that I can have it at night and be cozy. And so, yeah, it's called chocolatey chai, but it's herbal. So no caffeine, right? And so let's give it a little try. 3 to 5 minutes. I'm gonna do 5 minutes because this is a big cup. It smells interesting. I don't know if I'll like it. Okay. But yeah. How's it going? I feel like I'm like confusing myself between what I've talked about on the vlog so far versus what I talked about on the podcast. So I'm very scared that I'm like repeating myself, but I also feel like anybody who's gonna watch the podcast will also watch this video. So I'm sorry if I'm like repeating myself. But yeah, while my tea steeps, we have another 4 minutes. I'll show you guys the state of my Q-Week illustration. So I forget, I think maybe it had some colors down the last time I showed you, maybe. So I've kind of come to a point with it where it's, you know, it could be finished if I wanted it to be. It looks super blown out. Like the cat is actually not white. It's more of like a, it's too bright to see. It's, the cat is more of like a light coral color. It's not actually like that bright, and same with the like glow on her, but you guys can see the gist. Maybe if I zoom in. Yeah, it's more like that. And yeah, I like it. I've been working on it a lot today, and so I feel like I need some time away from it to kind of chill, reevaluate, come back to it. The one thing that I do think I kind of want to change is the background is just as detailed as the foreground. So I feel like it needs some more separation. Like maybe I'll change the color of the lines in the background so that they're a little bit warmer and like lighter, so that they recede a little bit more, or maybe I'll just like lighten the whole background just so that the foreground and background gets even more separation. But yeah, I like it. I think it has gone well. It's kind of cute, and I'm pleased. I'm pleased with myself and with it. So that's good. Let's go back to the kitchen and see what's up with this tea. Still have 2 minutes, okay. So yeah, it does smell very, like it does smell chocolatey, but kind of like almost fruity as well, like not like proper chocolate, but maybe like fake chocolate. You know what I mean? Like imagine a chocolate candy, but it's not made of chocolate, like that. I'm always very worried about trying herbal teas because I'm not like a big, like, you know how like some herbal teas that like grandmas have at their houses, they're like very like fruity and they're like bright red. I'm not a huge fan of teas like that. But I did try this like other herbal tea that was kind of like cinnamony and stuff, but it came in like weird tea bags without like strings or anything. So I wanted to find one that was a little bit easier to make. Maybe it'll taste good. Like maybe it'll taste different than how it smells, and I'm gonna add milk to it as well, which is key.
Oh my god.
Okay, here we go. Taste test. That is quite nice. I don't mind that. I don't put any sugar in my tea, but like it is already kind of like, it has like the spices and the like chocolatey-ness of it is already pretty sweet, so that's not bad. I like that. I can dig that, I think. I don't know if it'll be a mainstay, but yeah,
pretty good.
But yeah, like I said a little bit earlier, I'm just kind of spending the rest of my night. I'm rewatching The Crown, which this is my third time rewatching it, or it's my third time watching it. The first time I watched it, only like the first few seasons were out, and then it was a long time until the next season came out. So when that came out, I just felt like rewatching it just to get caught up again, caught back up to speed. And then now I haven't seen season 5 and 6 the last couple seasons, so I feel like that's enough to warrant an entire rewatch. So yeah, I'm back to season 1, and I have all the way up until season 6, and it's a great, like, I don't know, I like it for a background show. So that's gonna be the rest of my night. Should be a chill rest of my evening with my new chocolatey tea. It's not too dark. Kind of low-key is, though. Let's see what we can do about that. How's that, guys? How do we feel about that? Just a leaf in the foreground, which is fine. Okay, hi. I'm just sitting down to have my coffee and do my little morning check-in or whatever. But yeah, I wanted to come on and wrap up the vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I don't remember what I said or did in it, as I never do with these, but yeah, I think I did do some like good art making and all that stuff and rambling, as I tend to. I can really depend on myself to do that, if anything. But yeah, let me quickly show you what, I forget if I've shown like the final state of that cubic illustration that I was doing. I believe I have just, if I didn't show this before, I just added like some subtle gradation in the like framing element here. So it's like lighter at the bottom, darker at the top, so it has a bit more of a vibe. And then I brightened the background a touch just so that the stuff in the foreground stands out more. And then the whatever this is called, the window dividers, also stand out well. So I think I like it. I think it's done and I'm happy with it. And then obviously yesterday, as you guys saw,
I worked on the sticker, which I also love so much. If it'll, oh my god. There we go. Look at him. He's so cute. It's the cat in the postcard illustration, but just sitting on its own, and it has a leaf on its head, and it's just chilling, and I love it so much. And I hope you all love it too. So yeah, those will be my October Patreon rewards. I'm really kind of leaning into, you know, obviously like the postcard art or whatever is gonna be, I'm gonna try and like make it good and like my best work and like a illustration that I'm proud of. But the sticker I think is a great opportunity to just like do something fucking stupid, you know? I was very inspired by this one, which is the one for September, and it was my first kind of attempt at you know, a stupid sticker rather than an overly cute one. And I've said this before, but like, me myself, I prefer stuff like that. Like, if I'm gonna put a sticker on something, I'd like it to be either really well designed and like cool, or stupid and funny. And I think there's just so much joy in the latter. So I'm trying to lean into that. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. A thought that came to my mind recently is like, I don't know if I'm just kind of, cause I feel like in the past couple weeks, I've definitely come out of a state of being over analytical, like over analytical. Like, I'm typically like my normal state is over analytical, but I was a bit a level higher than that. So I'm coming out of that. So I still like feel some residual like insecurity around myself and what the fuck I'm doing here. So I've been thinking like, you know, I oh god, I hope what I'm saying is interesting. I hope my vlogs are good and blah 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 blah. And of course they are. They're fine. They're what they've always been. And what you guys have been watching me for and what you continue to watch me for, so I know like it's fine. But yeah, I don't know. I think I'm kind of reflecting on this whole YouTube thing, with like the recent revelations of like, you know, not wanting to take sponsorships and not really wanting to, I don't know, edit for retention so much anymore and just kind of be and do whatever. So yeah, I don't know. It's a balance, a difficult balance that I'm maybe overanalyzing right now, or like kind of struggling with, is like filming things because I want to film them and talking about things because I want to talk about them, right? That's on the one side, versus filming things, taking my camera along, talking to you guys, creating these like talking segments because I feel like I need to, or like I feel like the vlog needs some more of something. So I'm like, okay, so I gotta, you know, think of something to say. And it's like it's a difficult distinction between me talking about what's on my mind and what I wanna fucking talk about versus just like pulling something out of my ass because I feel like I need more footage for the vlog. But yeah, I don't know. That's just like something that's floating around in my head right now, and it's probably unnecessary to be overthinking this, and it'll, you know, work itself out. I just need to be honest with myself and then stay true to what this is and who I am, and yeah, focus on really trying to do what I want to do and say what I want to say and nothing more, you know what I mean? But yeah, it's weird. It's weird grappling with the pressure of like wanting to do uploads, you know, at least every couple weeks, wanting to create videos that are enjoyable to you guys, that are comforting to you guys, everything, blah, 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 while also telling myself that like,
that doesn't matter, and like I don't want to be creating for anybody but myself. But then that brings into question, like, okay, then why do I upload every couple weeks? Like, what is that for? If I'm telling myself that I don't actually care about the, like, the performance of my videos or whatever. But obviously, to an extent, I do. And, like, I want to keep growing and I want to keep doing that stuff. But maybe I think where I'm struggling is, like, I guess the way that I have been growing has been kind of motivated by, like, doing the same thing over and over and just, like, vlogging and just, like, doing whatever. And maybe to a point, like, I'm getting a little tired of that, or like I'm kind of coming to a point where I'm like, all right, I've done that, so like what's next? Maybe I'm just, like I said, overanalyzing it, but, or maybe I'm just like in a state of things are slowing down, it's coming into fall, I'm kind of having more time to think about this stuff, so I am. But yeah, it's weird. I don't know. I'll keep thinking about that, and I'll keep you guys updated on what I decide to do, or whether like I need to decide to do anything or announce anything. I don't. I just need to continue to be honest with myself and be led by that. Period. That's all. But yeah. Anyways, I'll end now. For real. And stop talking. But first, I need to thank my patrons, but we're in a very, like, contrasty shot right now, and I need not that, so that the names can actually be seen. Alright. Thank you to my patrons! I'm still a little concerned about how the names show up over here. Okay, one sec. Let's try this again. Thank you to my patrons! Thank you guys. I hope you're enjoying the Patreon so far. And each month when I, or each, you know, stage of the experience when I drop stuff, I hope you like it and I hope it's worth it to you. Thank you so much. Yeah, if you would like to support me directly and give me money, you can do that at Patreon, blah, 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 blah. But yeah, thank you for watching on YouTube as well. I appreciate your support on there, even though I'm grappling with, like, do I even care? Yes, I do. Of course I do. I'm human. Sorry. I'm like ending this on like a big, weird, so many thoughts going through my head and I'm confused, which is maybe like not a well-rounded conclusion to end a video on, but that's what I'm doing. So anyways, I'll talk to you guys in the next one. I'm going to journal now and maybe reflect on some of these thoughts that I'm thinking. That's all. Thanks again. I'll see y'all in a bit. Bye-bye.